I've got my coffee. I've got Melodyne. Let's talk about that. Not about the coffee. About Melodyne. Melodyne is one of the biggest revolution in music production. It's actually already pretty old. And it's actually what I call it, the opposite of autotune. Autotune is automatic tuning. And it also gives a, well, pretty noticeable effect.
Do you know what that is, kids? That's right, autotune.
Melodyne, on the other hand, is actually what I call manual tuning. There's a lot of hands-on going on in Melodyne. It is focused on making an as much as artifact-free tuned version as you can do. Melodyning isn't simple. It took me a pretty long time to learn it, to really learn how to make the perfect Melodyne. Perfect Melodyne doesn't really exist. And today I want to Melodyne a part of a, well, a bit of a special track to Melodyne because we took some special steps into Melodyning this one. The track I'm using is not Sandstorm by the Root. This track is called Amsterdam, which is a pretty nice title since I'm from Holland. It's made by an artist called SP, and I will link the EP with this track on it below, a Spotify link below. And you can also find him on other streaming services, of course. So this is Melodyne. I'm not going to talk you through the basics of Melodyne. I think there are a lot of other YouTubers talking about where all the buttons are for. So what I really like to have in Melodyne is, when I'm working on a lead vocal, is to have an instrumental. If you're just working on a lead vocal, you don't have the tuning reference. So you can, you know, have tones half a note up or half a note down. And with Melodyning, it's really important to listen and not only look at your sound. So the first sentence is down by the river.
Down by the river.
So if you listen to it, it's a bit fragile. And it's actually also what we wanted to make. So if I would pitch correct this whole down by the river part.
Down by the river. Down by the river. Down by the river.
And like get it as tight as I could.
Down by the river.
That fragile part is gone. So
down by the river. River. By the river.
It's almost robotic. So you can of course work around this problem by just, you know, changing small things in this. But what we notice that, well, if we just didn't apply Melodyne to that first sentence, that it actually felt the best. It gave us all the best feeling. Not only me, but also the artist SP in this case.
So down by the river.
So we kept it that way. That doesn't, however, mean that we didn't Melodyne the rest of the track, because the next sentence,
star fell from the sky,
was actually better when Melodyned. Let's also do that.
Star fell from,
fell from the sky.
Fell from the sky.
Sky.
From a star fell from the sky.
Most of all, the word star is much tighter now.
Star fell from the sky.
Like that.
It lit up the night.
It lit up the night. With Melodyne on it.
It lit up the night.
It lit up.
Lit up the night. Lit up the night. Lit up the night.
The night
lit up the night.
And like here, let's get it like
night lit up the night and put us lit up the night and put
the next sentence, however. Again, if I Melodyne this one tightly, so this is how it sounds without Melodyne.
And put a sparkle in her eye.
Now let's put Melodyne onto it.
And put a spark.
And put. Put a.
And put a. Put. And put a. And put a. And put a spark. and put a sparkle. Pull in, pull in, pull in, sparkle in around.
This is what it should be.
And put a sparkle in around.
Roughly, this is a quick melody, but I'm trying to get the point across. Again, we're getting a robot voice out of this.
Put a sparkle in around.
So that doesn't feel good. So if we reset it back again.
And put a sparkle in around.
Feels way better. Now let's move on to the chorus of this track, because that's a part where you actually want to have your melodyne set as tightly as possible.
No one can break us, it's just you and I.
The reason why is several reasons. Well, first of all, there are some notes that are, you know, a bit too low, but also there's a lot of music in the background over there, so you can't get away with it. A vocal that's a bit out of tune, you will get problems with mixing, with trying to blend everything. If it's pitched at, well, actually the correct tone and the correct tune, and also the smallest details are pitched correctly, it will blend much easier and better together in the mix, and it will also sound better. Let's show you how I did this. The first word,
no one,
no one,
no one, no one.
No one.
No one.
No, not yet. So you need the note in between to get the slide correctly. So
no one.
I cannot do this. Doesn't.
No one.
Doesn't sound good. And I also cannot do this.
No one.
Doesn't sound good. So the note in between.
No one can break us. It's just.
It's just you and I. Like that, so.
Break us, it's just you and I. No one.
No one.
No one can. No one can. No one can break us. They won't even try. Oh.
Let's also get this one.
No one can break us. They won't even try. Oh.
Like that. So I hope that you guys are getting the point that I'm trying to get across. It's a bit difficult for me because Melodyne is almost on the automatic pilot for me. The thing is, you just have to use these two things, your ears. The problem with a lot of people that try to Melodyne is that they want to get it tight, but too tightly. Think about what you're doing and also use your ears and use your feel over here. That's my biggest tip for when you're starting with Melodyne and when you want to learn more about Melodyning. Pick a vocal that's already pretty good and try to get it perfect without losing the feel of the vocal. Now the other thing with Melodyne is people call using Melodyne on a vocal cheating, and I do not agree with them. The thing is, Melodyne is just a tool, just as an EQ is a tool, if you ask me. We all want to get the best out of the performance. So the music industry right now is made that almost all the songs that we hear is tuned to a perfect pitch, and that makes that if you try to mix a track, try to make a track without having the vocals like pitched perfectly, pitched really tightly, people will notice that and people won't prefer that because they are used to hearing that perfect pitched vocals. So you almost have to do it, even with singers that are already pretty good. Just tightening it up, that last bit with Melodyne, helps a lot and makes production a lot better. You will also notice that when mixing, it just sounds so much better when everything is perfect in key. And here's also another thing to think about. If I'm recording vocals with a vocalist, I'm going to make videos about recording vocals whenever I find a vocalist that is interested in that. But when you're recording with a vocalist and when you're doing three takes and one of the takes has a perfect feel, like feels just right, and the other take is just pitched perfectly but is cold as ice and doesn't get across the emotion of the track, then I would prefer to use the first take that has the emotion in it, and then just correct it a bit with Melodyne or whatever pitch correcting software you are using. So yeah, that's how I think about Melodyne. I think it's a tool, and I think that it should be used whenever you need to use it for the enjoyment of the listener. So yeah, I want to end this video with those thoughts. Let me know your thoughts about Melodyne. And also, if you want me to do follow-up videos about Melodyne, I will do a follow-up video about how I did the mixing and mastering of this track. I think next week, I'm not sure about that, but I will do a follow-up video about this track. Let me know in the comments below. Also, while you're doing things, make sure to check out Patreon. I will link it over here. You can get early access to my videos and support this channel by pledging a bit on Patreon. And if you don't want to do it, you can also check one of my other videos over here. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys again in the next one. Bye bye.